Ladies and gentlemen, hello. Hello and welcome to our season concert finale. This is our last concert of the season. What a season it has been. If you've been following this orchestra for the past year, you might remember, or vaguely remember, depending on how much wine you had, the October 3rd Music Stories and the MSO Gala. You might remember the wonderful, beautiful, talented Nicole Warner that sang Summer Nights of Berlioz and Enigma Variations. And today we're concluding the season with Tchaikovsky, celebrating his 175th birthday. Why Tchaikovsky? Well, his birthday for one, but the other question is, and the question that I ask myself sometimes, why is Tchaikovsky's music so popular? Why does his music speak directly to one's soul, one's emotions? It's true that critics during his time hated Tchaikovsky and his music, but the general population, the general audience loved it. And so I asked myself, like, what about it, about these harmonies, these rhythms, these melodies that's so attractive to the audience? And although I don't have a direct answer or definitive answer, I might be able to provide a clue based on something I've done a couple of years ago. We nerdy conductors do weird things on free time. One of them is reading diaries of other people. Okay, that sounded wrong, but you know. When Tchaikovsky was 33, and by the time he died, well, 2 years before he died, he kept a daily log of all his Snapchat activities. Snapshot activities of all the things he would do throughout the day. I've taken the time and read through all of them. 20 years worth of daily logs of what I did. And the strange thing, as in the case of Tchaikovsky, he never meant these records to be public. They were his private. Sometimes ambitious composers will keep a diary with the thought in the back of their mind that when I die, people will do research, people will read this, and better understand who I was as a person, as a composer. Not so Tchaikovsky, because his diaries contain some rather embarrassing and moments. I mean, it was his private thing that he kept for himself. What's unique about the content of these diaries is what he found important, or what he put down for his later recollection when he would go back and look at it. His normal day, as he would write, would start something along the lines like this. Woke up. I'm not going to do this in Russian accent. I'll just do it. Woke up. Had tea. Engaged in an argument with Sasha. I feel bad. Hope this doesn't mature into a conflict. Went for a stroll. Talked with a neighbor. Went to the bar. Got drunk. Next day, woke up, head hurts. Sasha is blaming me for so-and-so. This type of record would go on for pages and pages, and only in short notices you will have things like worked. Struggled with work. For a casual reader who never heard of Tchaikovsky, were he, she, to read through it, you might think that Tchaikovsky's career was a social observer or a social talents person who just walked around, got in business, other people's business, got in arguments, and what have you. But I think this is perhaps could be the key as to why Tchaikovsky's music is so direct to us, because for the most part, throughout his life, throughout his diaries, and other writings, he was so preoccupied on today, day-to-day basis with his relationship with other people. He would write things like, I hope she's not angry at me, or he's not angry at me. What have I done? What will I do? There was this always preoccupation with how does my heart or how do I relate to another person? And perhaps, just perhaps, that found a way into his music and why his music speaks directly to everyone. You don't have to know too much theory or much knowledge about music. His music just seems to have a direct contact or a direct line to our emotions. The next piece that we will play is Martslav. But before we will do, there are some important names and companies we have to thank. They're so important, I even wrote them down. This will be a constant mistake to get it wrong. Our sponsors today are Lake Country Power, Cliffs Natural Resources, Essentia Health, Minnesota Power, and WEVE Radio Station. There's also a questionnaire in your programs that we'd like you to figure out that would help us assess and make better decisions as to how to serve you better. Again, thank you so much for coming and enjoy March Song. I will speak for the last time. Between now and the end of the concert, there is 50 minutes of very challenging music. And to delay the start of that, I will tell you just a couple things. Concert hall is a very lively place. And throughout the concert, many things can happen. And have happened. Injuries, players passing out. There's one instance of a conductor, the name of Vladimir Ashkenazi, that got so involved in conducting that while conducting, he was conducting with his right hand, and then some left hand gesture pierced straight through. Right. That's a good reaction, by the way. It's painful. And the concertmaster had to lead the entire concert. There is also one instance this happened in Germany where a particular trumpet player was not very happy with the conductor or his tempi and brought a firearm and said, "I will execute this man because I hate him so much." This was right before the second half. Police was called in, the man was taken away, and Herbie von Karajan said, "You'll just have to imagine the second trumpet part." And just like went on to conducting as if like nothing happened. Nothing of the sort happened today. But I would like to relay a personal story before we start playing. This was 4 years ago. I was conducting Tchaikovsky symphony for the first time. This was my first symphony. It was Tchaikovsky's fourth symphony, and it was Minnesota, University of Minnesota, a campus orchestra, which essentially it's an orchestra of people who just show up, it's not in the major, and they just play. I was advised that, you know, one of the hardest symphonies of Tchaikovsky IV would be a great piece to do with this orchestra. It was a very bad advice. I had 7 rehearsals that were 30 minutes long. The warm-up before the concert, disaster. I mean, disaster where people didn't show up because they had some sort of test, you know, with their major. I mean, we couldn't even start and end together like 12 hours. It was that bad. But there was no way I could cancel it. So here I was, 5 minutes before going on stage in my dressing room, really thought that I will have a heart attack on the podium. And to prove to you that this was not some sort of like a thing that I just randomly do, like I called my parents and told them, "I love you so much. Thank you for everything you've done in my life. If I die, it's none of your fault. This is the cause of bad advice. I love you." And Mom said, "What's going on? Like, what's happening?" I said, "I'm about to go conduct Tchaikovsky's fourth symphony." Mom said, "You have to get out of this profession. It will kill you." The first movement is about 20 minutes of the most difficult stuff you can think, time-wise, rhythm-wise, harmony-wise. All I remember is I gave a downbeat and somehow we were at the end of the first movement. I literally don't remember anything that happened between then and the end of the movement. But nonetheless, survival is victory. There are a few members in this orchestra, or more than maybe a few, who think that they might have a heart attack during the performance of this symphony. It is not easy. And I just have to say how proud I am of all of you for taking on the symphony, and they did such a fantastic job with them, with the symphony. There are not very many college orchestras who can perform and tackle the symphony. So I'm really proud. I'm really proud of this town, and I'm proud of the support that you gave the symphony. If by the end of this concert you feel inspired to write checks with many zeros, we will not refuse their acceptance. Thank you for coming today and enjoy Tchaikovsky's Fifth Symphony.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.